March 1st. Wow. Just as I thought. In the blink of an eye, sorry. Yeah. It's crazy. Yeah. Hope everyone is enjoying the beginning of this new month in 2024. Wow. So much. Yeah, I just ordered some stuff from this restaurant that I usually go to. And I was saying, let me just go ahead and grab something while I watch something. Grab something to eat while I watch something. Just a couple of things. Not that much. Okay. So all the new shows and everything that's coming out now, it's like kind of overwhelmed. Well, not really overwhelmed. I'm just saying, like, I don't know if we watch the same stuff. Some of the stuff I know a lot of people watch and stuff. It's like the way that it goes, the way that it's going now, it's like they would only put out one a week. So my thing is, instead of waiting a whole week for something, I'm like, let me pause on it. Let me just stop, pause a little bit. And let a couple of weeks go by, a couple of months go by, whatever. In a few episodes, wrap up, right? And then try to binge that way. But it's kind of like, at the same time, you have to really stay clear of the social media and stuff. And the same thing, you have to stay clear of the social media and stuff, because a lot of times people will be posting spoilers and stuff. And like, oh, I didn't want to see this right now. I didn't want to know about that part, this part, whatever. Right? So, that's a little bit of the challenging part. But, yeah, that's where I'm at right now. So what I'm doing is, I'll try and find like an older show or something, where it's like a lot of seasons and stuff, a lot of episodes. So that way, any of the new shows that I wanted to watch. Have any excuse not to watch or whatever, instead of being like, oh, I can't wait, I can't hold on to this any longer, I need to watch it. Nah, let me just pause and just chill a little bit, right? And while I'm enjoying this show, I won't even be thinking of this, that, and the third, right? This new show that's out, whatever. And especially if all the newer shows right now don't really have that much episodes. So it's like, it's just back in the day, like, where are all the good shows? Where did all the good shows go? You know, where it's like sitcoms, kind of like sitcoms, whatever. You know, it's wholesome family type stuff, right? Like, everything is just different now. Everything's just different now, you know? So it's like, what am I gonna do? Right? So just looking back at some of the older shows, it's like nostalgic a little bit, right? And you're just like reminiscing on some of the stuff that you used to watch and how you felt in that moment, at that time, when you watch this or that, whatever. And it's like, oh, I remember that time, or I remember when I was this age, whatever. And I did this, I did that. Right. Banana bread. And you just hate when they just give you like a couple, just a couple packets. Even though it's a lot of the food. And that's just crazy to me. One of my favorites is tuna. Tuna sandwich. Pizza. You know, I keep putting that in my plate, like, I'm never gonna eat a pickle. You never catch me eating a pickle. It's not gonna happen. Period. Never had one, and I never will. Favorite. Burrito. Breakfast burrito. No, I don't. I don't eat chicken bone. That's the only thing. But yeah, some of the shows I was talking about is more of stuff I haven't seen or whatever. I'm just saying the whole I'm gonna say 2000s, maybe 2017, something like that. The older shows. I haven't seen much of them. So I'm looking back and I'm seeing what I haven't watched yet or whatever. So that way I could look at it or whatever. Because as I said, because of the way that it's made, it's more of, you know, a family type stuff. So there's a lot of it and all that stuff. But it's not like I'm watching this. When I watch something, I don't rewatch it. When I watch it once, that's it. Doesn't matter how good it is, unless it was. There's only one movie that I watched, and I could always like. I could always like rewatch over and over. It's my favorite movie, The Hulk. But other than that, like anything else, any shows, any movies, whatever, I watch it once and that's it. So I have the movie that's talking about, I have it like downloaded on my computer, whatever. And then, like I said, I put it on the CD, on a DVD, whatever. But anything that I watch, whatever, like after I watch it, that's it. There's no rewatching, whatever. So whenever I talk about like being nostalgic and all that stuff, what I'm trying to say is like it reminds me of this show, it reminds me of that show, it reminds me of this show, it reminds me of that show. So it's more of that than hey, I'm watching this to pass the time because I know what it is or I've watched it before. No, it's not like that. Like hey, from this time period and that time period, whatever, what do they have? Because I feel like 2017 is like the tip. Excuse me. It's like the tip of where shows tilted. I wouldn't say tilted. I feel like in 2017, all the shows in 2017 that were posted in 2017. You know, probably years before, whatever. A year before, whatever. But I feel like when it's like in 2017, when it's posting 2017, it's like, that's the last year. I don't say the last year that it was good. It just has this feeling to it. I can't explain. This feeling to it, almost like you're there in the room with them. It's almost like it's not actually the show. all the family drama and all that stuff. Like, you kind of get invested, you know, a little bit. The bad part is when, no matter how long it is, it's gonna end, right? The bad part is when you get to that ending, or close to the ending, and you're just like, wait a minute. Well, yeah. Yeah, I'll explain it. It just has that feeling to it. So it's like, you know that even though you're really waiting for your main show, whatever, it just started, you're just like, oh, I could definitely continue watching this because of how it makes me feel and all that stuff. Yeah, don't mind me. I know this video is turning into a mukbang. Strain the sweater real quick. But yeah. Sometimes I just like to binge eat. No, it is. Just not in the mood for cooking, whatever. I mean, sorry about that. I can't tell you right now. Why I'm ordering a lot more than usual. Definitely, one day I will. It's crazy, definitely. My does this show. And so it just came out. Just started showing, just started airing. Definitely want to check it out. Yeah, it was getting a lot of attention on social media and stuff, so a lot of people were talking about it and all that stuff. So I'm like, even though it also does the same thing where it's like one episode a week or whatever, I'm thinking I might give it a chance and to see what the hype is about it and everything, because mind that sound. Here's my eater. Yeah. I was saying, I was thinking of giving it a chance and actually checking out, even if I have to wait, you know, a week and all that stuff before I see more episodes. I think they're on like 2 or 3 right now. I don't think it's 4. But I think it was called Old and Bougie, something like that. I feel like it falls in line, well, not directly, but kind of like in line with the whole reality TV and all that stuff. Like Love and Hip Hop, you know, all the franchises and all that stuff. All the different parts, different cities, you know, having their own take on it. Which I have not watched. I only watched one of them. I don't know why, I just can't get into any of them. Any of the other ones, any of the main ones. Maybe I might, maybe not, I don't know. But probably, I don't know, probably not. But yeah, this show, definitely I have to check it out, see what they're talking about, see what the hype is about and all that stuff. And, you know, just see how it is. I started, we were like 5-10 minutes into the show, and I'm like, this is gonna be crazy. Because the title gives off an impression of what it might be. But when you look at it, it's almost like clickbait. I don't want to say clickbait. You're saying bold and bougie. Obviously, you're thinking, you know, women just like women that are dominating the entrepreneurial women and stuff like that, right? That are doing whatever they feel like doing, and you know, working hard, and you know. Reaping the benefits of their hard work and all that stuff. And showing off their expenses and stuff, this and that, whatever. But, you know, that's kind of like the mindset that you're getting, but it's not really what it is, right? So that's what I'm saying, like, when it started, I already had a mindset of what it might have been. But I'm glad that it wasn't. But at the same time, like I said, it kind of falls in line with the whole LHH and so all that stuff. So it's almost like that's a feeling that I get. And I started watching it and all that stuff. Like I said, I haven't really watched it. Some of the other ones and stuff. Only one of them, the one in Miami, but all the other ones, it's almost like most of the clips and stuff you'll see on social media and all that stuff. So it's like you kind of already have a take on how it is and all that stuff. You know, this person, all these people are rich, feel like they could cheat or whatever, or they want to be faithful because they have money and they have the attention and all that stuff. And a whole bunch of fighting over there, different fights. Who broke up with who and all the family drama and different stuff. It's almost like, come on, like, spray it out, like, almost kind of like, right? But, like, at the same time, you're like, what else am I gonna watch? What are you doing? Right? So, I haven't really gotten into it, basically, that's what I'm trying to say. But, that's a kind of like, not really, but kind of like the feeling that I'm getting while I was watching it. So I paused it a little bit. I paused it, so I didn't finish the first episode. So, like I said, I'm thinking I might get into it. See what it's more of what it's about and all that stuff. And see if I like it, see how it is. But like I said, a lot of people were talking about it. A lot of people were saying a lot of stuff about it and all that stuff. So it was getting a lot of reviews. Good, bad, I don't know. I didn't check it out in detail, but I know definitely like a lot of eyes on it, right? Because it's new. Anytime something new comes up, it's like everybody's on it. Everybody's trying to get their take on it, see what it's about, and everything, and trying to post about it and do different stuff, right? So yeah, I want to like look at it at least, see what it's about. But go ahead and finish up this food real quick because. I'm gonna eat all of it right now on camera. I'm just gonna complete it. Just gonna finish it up while I'm watching this. Like I said, the show is one of the older shows and stuff I was watching. Just to pass the time right now. I know I have a lot to do. And time flies, like literally, it really flies. So, watching a couple of episodes there. Chores and errands and stuff later on, not even that long. Bring the clothes, bring the laundry over there, Mr. Neil over there, different stuff. So, yeah, it's a lot. You know why, but they cut them in half and they just like, you know, put them on a grill or something. You can tell it was hot and all that stuff. So, yeah. I wanted this video to be a little longer as opposed to the other ones and stuff. I prefer the corn. I always get the blueberry. I don't know why.